Hello everyone, my name is John Chen and I'm an academic neuro-ophthalmologist practicing in Rochester, Minnesota. I think neuro-ophthalmology is one of the most fulfilling subspecialties among ophthalmology. Because neuro-ophthalmologists deal with diseases affecting the optic nerve and also the connections with the brain, we not only have the potential to make vision-saving diagnoses, but we can make life-saving diagnoses as well, such as aneurysms and stroke. It's a profession where we get to continue to be the doctors that we had trained to be and utilize our knowledge from general medicine and neurology. This also leads to very fulfilling relationships with our colleagues within ophthalmology and also colleagues outside ophthalmology, including neurology, neurosurgery, and neuroradiology. These relationships make coming to work a lot of fun. These collaborations have also led to large advances in understanding some diseases within neuro-ophthalmology. Next, I would like some of my fellow neuro-ophthalmology colleagues to share some of their stories and thoughts on the field of neuro-ophthalmology.
My name is Vivek Patel. I'm a neuro-ophthalmologist at an academic medical center, and like so many of my colleagues, fortunate to have a diverse practice. This includes patients with disorders of the visual pathways that span anywhere from the front of the eye to the back of the brain, and anything in between, as well as patients that come from services like neurology and neurosurgery, as well as other disciplines within ophthalmology. We have a chance to continue to develop and learn on a daily basis. And I do so in the clinic about 60 to 65% of my time, about 20% of the time in surgery, because Fridays are devoted to surgery for me, as well as I spend time incorporated within all of that on research and academic activities as much as I can. These types of endeavors do allow you to make an international footprint, and so many of our colleagues are internationally known for their ability to teach and practice neuro-ophthalmology. Our field is well developed in North America as well as many aspects of the world, and less developed in others, so there is a great opportunity to make an impact, either it's through lectures or visiting professorships or even just spending time in surgical or clinical domains in all parts of the world. International ophthalmology does not include just cataract camps and such surgical endeavors, but you really can make a difference by spreading your expertise.
Hi, my name is Courtney Francis, and I'm an academic neuro-ophthalmologist in Seattle, Washington. I chose to become a neuro-ophthalmologist because I love the intersection between ophthalmology and neurology, the diversity of conditions treated, and the ability to collaborate with a wide range of specialties, including neurosurgery, neurology, and radiation oncology. Neuro-ophthalmologists are the diagnostic detectives in ophthalmology, and it is always satisfying to be able to make a diagnosis that was previously elusive, providing answers to patients and potentially a path to treatment. My clinic days are spent evaluating patients with optic nerve or visual pathway disorders, as well as double vision and other cranial nerve palsies. In the OR, I primarily perform strabismus surgery on adults. Correcting double vision and eye misalignment is one of the most rewarding parts of my job, as patients are so incredibly appreciative of their improved quality of life after surgery. I've been in practice for 10 years and continue to be enthusiastic every day about my profession.
Hello, my name is Ray Fadeshina, and I'm an ophthalmology-trained neuro-ophthalmologist practicing at a large academic institution. I chose a career in neuro-ophthalmology because this specialty allows me to have a career focused on the study of the connection between the eyes and the brain, as well as treat patients with neuro-ophthalmic conditions medically and surgically. I have been fortunate to be able to help many patients over my career. However, one that stands out to me in particular is a young woman who came to the ER a few years ago with worsening vision loss and headaches. She was found to have bilateral optic nerve swelling from raised intracranial pressure and was started on medications and discharged home. She came to my clinic a week later, however, with worsening vision and headaches, as well as worsening optic nerve swelling, and was unable to keep her medications down due to severe nausea and vomiting. She was admitted to the hospital urgently, and I performed bilateral optic nerve fenestrations to release spinal fluid pressure around her optic nerves and keep her from losing more vision. She did very well after surgery, and in fact, experienced a significant improvement in her vision and visual fields. Her and her family were very grateful because she was now able to continue her dream of pursuing a degree in graphic design going to college that summer. This was a very rewarding experience for me. I was able to help a patient who was losing vision due to my specialized neuro-ophthalmic training, and I was very happy I was able to do that.
Hello, I'm Colin McClellan, and I'm an academic neuro-ophthalmologist in Minneapolis, Minnesota. I operate once weekly and have an adult strabismus surgery practice. My time is divided between 70% clinical and 30% academic time. If you like the show House MD, you would love being a neuro-ophthalmologist. We commonly see patients with vision loss of unclear etiology, and the problem may localize anywhere from the front of the eye all the way to the back of the brain. We often diagnose brain tumors, aneurysms, giant cell arteritis, multiple sclerosis, and occult retinal disease. Because we see so many fascinating cases, our specialty creates a natural platform to become an effective and respected teacher. Residents and practicing ophthalmologists everywhere worry about missing a serious neuro-ophthalmologic diagnosis, and once you become a neuro-ophthalmologist, you will become the expert that everyone turns to for their most challenging cases. It's very gratifying.
I hope you enjoyed hearing about neuro-ophthalmology. As you can see, we all love what we do, and it's a very fulfilling subspecialty. We have a very active young neuro-ophthalmology group called YONO that you are all welcome to join. If you have any questions about neuro-ophthalmology, feel free to reach out to me or my colleagues anytime.